In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a stop motion like this in Adobe Photoshop. After you've finished taking all the pictures you want for your stop motion video, open up the Photoshop app and make a new file. First thing you're going to want to do is click File at the top, and then go down the list until you see Scripts. Then click Load Files into Stack. By selecting Browse, you can find all the pictures you took and import them into Photoshop. For me, I want to use the photos on an SD memory card. I have made a little stop motion of a Lego man walking. It doesn't matter what your pictures are of or how you took them, as long as you can import them into Photoshop. Click Open when you are happy with the photos you have selected, and they should start to appear as layers. It may take a few minutes for them to load in. Next, you will need to go to the top menu and find Window. Go down the list of options until you find Timeline. Make sure this is checked because this panel will be used for the next step. In this new panel, click Create Frame Animation. Then go up to the little button on the right and select Make Frames from Layers. This will make a sequence of the images you imported in the timeline. Go to the start of the timeline and click Play. The images will likely be playing the wrong way around. To fix this, select all the photos and click the small button again and find Reverse Frames. Click this and play the photos again. It should now be playing in the correct order. Now for the next step, you need to decide on the frame rate of your stop motion. This typically ranges from 10 to 30 frames per second. To adjust this, select all the photos again and open the drop-down menu below one of the photos. Click 0.1 seconds. This means Photoshop will show each photo for 0.1 seconds, or 10 frames per second. If you want the video to play a bit faster with a higher frame rate, change the duration to a lower number. For this stop motion, I'm going to go with 0.08 seconds. This ends up being around 12 frames per second. To figure out the frame rate you want, you can just go 1 divided by the duration. For example, 1 divided by 0.1 is 10, so that will play the video at 10 frames per second. Once you are happy with your frame rate, go up to File and then Export. Scroll down until you see Render Video. A menu will appear. You can choose where you want the file to go and what resolution and size it should be. There are even presets you can pick for things like YouTube. Once you are happy with that, click Render and Photoshop will start making the video for you. Here is my final product. If you want to learn how to edit stop motions in Premiere Pro, I highly suggest watching this video on the screen now. If you have any further questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I will do my best to answer as many as I can. Hope this video was helpful.